DNS Edge is a DNS security solution that sits between an organization's internal client devices and its corporate DNS servers. Edge gives organizations the ability to monitor and apply policies to DNS traffic in order to control access to domains. Edge administrators can review traffic for unusual or potentially malicious behavior. This can help them identify compromised devices, protect against insider threats, and spot lateral movement of malware and then take appropriate action. Architecturally, DNS Edge is composed of two elements, a series of first-hop DNS servers called service points, and a customer-specific cloud-managed Edge instance for configuring policies and analyzing DNS data. Service points are first-hop DNS servers deployed as part of an organization's DNS infrastructure. These service points are virtual appliances that act as forwarding DNS servers with caching capability. As first-hop devices, all DNS queries from clients pass through service points, including queries for both internal and external resources. Service points enforce policies that allow normal DNS traffic to pass and block or redirect queries that are identified as potential threats. If queries pass the policy evaluation process, they are then forwarded to the appropriate server in the organization's DNS infrastructure for resolution. In addition to applying policies and controlling traffic, service points deliver the DNS query data into the customer's Edge instance for analysis and storage. The Edge instance represents a cloud-based management layer and receives and hosts DNS data streamed by service points. DNS Edge users interact with the Edge instance via a web user interface. Queries from all service points are available for examination in the Edge instance. Data is analyzed in the Edge instance, and statistics are displayed on a dashboard. These statistics include the most frequently queried domains and queries per second for a given period. DNS Edge supports the use of API calls to access data, to perform administrative tasks, and to support automation and integration. API support allows for integration with systems like SIEM. This allows data to be pulled from the Edge instance and analyzed using applications such as Splunk. Service points are configured in the Edge instance. Policies, domain lists, and other configuration elements are also created and managed there. Whenever an upgrade to Edge is available, it is sent to the customer's Edge instance. Every few minutes, service points contact the Edge instance. This communication is secured by SSL. During this communication, service points check for available updates to Edge. If any are available, the service point pulls down the updates. In addition, the service point checks for changes to policies and policy actions. When an administrator changes the address of any DNS servers to which the service point forwards queries, the service point also pulls this information from the customer's Edge instance. Let's look at what happens when a service point receives a DNS query from a client. The first action a service point takes upon receiving a query is to examine it for potential threat indicators. These indicators include characteristics associated with DNS tunneling, such as queries for uncommon record types or an unusually large number of characters in the hostname. The threat assessment engine also looks for a high degree of randomness in the characters in the queried domain's name. Such randomness is associated with the use of domain generation algorithms. Additional threat indicators include queries for domain names that include the most frequently abused top-level domains, and queries that match a list of suspect domain names. If any indicators are found, the service point classifies the query with the associated threat type. Next, the service point compares the query against any locally enforced policies. Policies can be defined based on a variety of criteria, including threat types, lists of domains for which policy action should be taken, or the source IP address of the query. Policies can also be set to limit queries to specific times of day. If the query matches the policy settings, then the service point acts upon the query. The policy engine contains four configurable policy actions. The monitor action is used to provide visibility into queries. The query and response are logged, but are allowed to continue unhindered. There are no further actions taken by the service point. Block is used as a means of preventing clients from querying certain domains or blocks of IP addresses. As the name suggests, this policy action blocks access to the requested resource. The service point responds to blocked queries with a non-existent domain or NX domain message, which effectively informs the client that the name does not exist. The query is not forwarded for resolution. However, it is still sent to the Edge instance for analysis. Blocking prevents the client from reaching a potentially dangerous domain or hostname, and also from reaching the rest of the organization's DNS infrastructure. The redirect action is an alternative to simply blocking the query. Instead of returning an NX domain to the client, the service point redirects the query to another fully qualified domain name, such as a web page informing the user that he or she was about to access a domain or host name that was not allowed. Such a safe page is also known as a walled garden. The allow action is the most restrictive of the four policy actions. A policy configured with the allow action is generally used to restrict a device to a limited number of domain names or host names. When the query matches any of the allowed items, it is forwarded to the next hop DNS server. All other queries are blocked and an NX domain response is returned to the client. A good use case for a policy with the allow action is a point-of-sale device, which normally should only need to contact a limited number of resources, such as inventory and financial processing systems. Such a device, if compromised, could be directed to send queries to a command and control domain, or be used for data exfiltration via tunneling. Restricting queries to a set of domains or host names prevents these devices from being used by malicious actors for these purposes. If the query is not blocked or redirected, then the service point forwards the query to the address of one or more defined DNS forwarders. DNS Edge provides additional intelligence and flexibility to the caching layer with the namespaces feature. Each namespace includes a unique set of DNS forwarders to which a query might be directed. Service points can be configured with one, two, or three different namespaces. Using namespaces, a service point routes queries to the appropriate DNS servers based on where the query should be sent. For example, an administrator for Example Corporation can route all queries for internal resources in the corporate domain example.com to one or more authoritative internal servers, and all other queries to an external recursive server. Another function of the namespaces feature is that it enables a service point to resolve a query against different instances of the same domain name. For example, a company might have public and private versions of its domain, one that is internet accessible, and the other that is accessible only from inside the organization. Suppose that only the public version of the example.com domain contains the record name www. Normally, a DNS server can only resolve queries against one instance of a domain. As a result, the DNS administrator would be forced to keep the record up to date in both copies of the domain. Using the namespaces feature, a service point can try another instance of the domain if the requested record is not found in the first. In this example, the service point would first forward the query to the private version of example.com. When the record is not found in this version of the domain, and an NX domain is returned, the service point would try the next namespace, which is associated with the public version of the domain. The query is forwarded to the public DNS servers, and because they contain the www record, the query can be resolved successfully. After a query passes through the various stages, if the response is not blocked or redirected, the response is returned to the service point. The service point logs the response and passes it to the client. At the same time, the service point sends the query to the customer's Edge instance, where it can be stored and analyzed. Administrators log into the web-based interface to review and analyze data in their organization's Edge instance. The dashboard displays information gathered from the logged data, including statistics about queries and policy actions taken. More detailed information about queries can be found on the DNS Activity page. Displayed information includes details such as the date and time of the query, the source IP address that issued the query, the site from which the query was sent, the query name and type, the response code, and the policy action that was taken. Clicking on a query displays a detailed view of that query, showing additional details such as any thread indicators with which the query is tagged, policy actions that were applied, and the records returned in response to the query. The Thread Activity tab shows queries that were flagged as potential threats. Administrators can filter the DNS Activity and Thread Activity tabs by a number of different criteria. For example, the list can be filtered to display queries sent during a specified period, sent from a specific IP address, or that were identified as a specific type of threat. The customer instance is also where administrators manage policies, namespaces, domain lists, and other details. Edge users can access the BlueCat DNS Edge User Guide from the web interface. BlueCat DNS Edge is unlike other security solutions, such as your network firewall or web proxy. Because it's client-facing, it provides visibility and control over every DNS request and response. This helps you uncover and take action against threats before, during, and after a breach. DNS Edge gives you greater visibility by letting you view both internal and external traffic for every client type, correlate query and response logs to originating hosts, and root out patient zero and other infected devices. Edge lets you block malicious DNS behavior like data exfiltration, or control the traffic from your IoT devices and critical systems so that they access only those domains you want them to access. Leverage DNS Edge smart analytics across all DNS queries on your network to detect behavior like data exfiltration, tunneling, and DGA, or integrate with SIM or Splunk to correlate with other tools. DNS Edge allows cybersecurity and networking teams to leverage the vast amount of data sitting in DNS to provide visibility, control, and intelligence of their network. For more information on Edge, contact us today. To get more information about BlueCat training content like this, visit bluecatnetworks.com/training.